and welcome to L10. We have a great show lined up for you, but first, some headlines. Last week, the Inter-Art Council created the first ever 3D student art display. Pioneered by fourth former Ankita Suri, the virtual gallery serves as a substitute for the annual student art show in the Gruss Center for Arts and Design's Hutchins Galleries. Earlier this week, the McClellan House hosted its annual dinner virtually to benefit SEGA, an organization that funds a secondary school in Tanzania for girls. SEGA representatives spoke to attendees at the dinner, which also featured student performances. Despite being away from campus, Laurentians are still committed to community service. Our arts team brings you the story of how three students are using the arts to serve their community during this difficult time.
I'm giving back to the community by organizing a service project for Morris Hall, which is one of the nursing homes close to Lawrenceville. And I'm having students send in virtual performances, so singing, dancing, even reading poetry, playing an instrument that we can send to the residents there to let them know that we are still thinking about them and that, you know, they're in our hearts and our minds.
I'm selling products and merchandise with artwork that I've designed on them on a website called Redbubble. And all of the proceeds that I get from selling these products will be donated to the Inspira Health COVID-19 Emergency Response Fund.
One of my mother's friends is a nurse, and she had mentioned how there was a shortage of masks and stuff. So we got fabric and all this stuff and just started using the sewing machine.
Music specifically and any kind of performance and art is a really good way to open up people's emotions and hearts, and it reaches people. It's a universal language basically.
There's so many aspects to art, like the colors and design. So I thought that I would just be able to express most meaningful message through my art to the community.
You can learn how to make a mask really easily. And you can give them to local healthcare workers because they do desperately need them.
An important mentality people should have is, I think feeling your feelings and being okay with being sad or feeling okay with being unproductive. You know, this is a really weird time for everyone. This is a kind of trauma and people are going through a lot of grief.
It's important for all of us to lend a hand and contribute to the efforts, no matter how small or large the impact may be.
If you do have anything that you could give back to the community, that you give back to people, then I feel that those people should.
It's important for people to stay hopeful and stay resilient because really nothing can beat us if we all stay together and lend a hand for humanity.
I think just trying to find joy and positivity in little things. And for me, one thing that's really helped is making art.
As Griswold housemaster, Spanish master, and a coach, it is amazing that Mr. Cuniff has time to perfect his yo-yo tricks. Third former Dylan Chowdhury brings you the story of Mr. Cuniff's passion for the yo-yo.
So how I started yo-yoing? Actually, my father. So my father grew up, he was born in 1951. He grew up in Oregon, and from a young age, he started yo-yoing. And his yo-yo collection is sitting on the wall of my family home. He's got probably 30 or 40. And so when I was eight, he taught me how to throw. We had the old plastic Yo-Mega fireball. You throw it down, it sleeps for a minute, and then the brain in it tells it to come back. So I yo-yoed through middle school probably, and then last spring I went to Japan. And I happened to go during his birthday, and I said, what better gift to get my father than a yo-yo from Japan? And we went, we scoured the city, and we found yo-yos. And they were not the yo-yos I was accustomed to seeing. These I threw and they slept, meaning they didn't come back. And when I wanted to come back, they didn't come back. And I didn't know what happened. And I came to find out that in the time from middle school until then, the yo-yo world had taken on what's called unresponsive yo-yoing, which allows for wider gaps in the yo-yos, string tricks, more elaborate, whatever imagery, and ever since then I've been hooked. It's kind of therapeutic, and it's just kind of a way to challenge myself and take my mind off things. And so I do collect. I have a wide variety of shapes, sizes, weights, designs, and it's fun. It's a good way to blow off some steam, give myself a little treat. Most of my collection is what we call organic shape. So this is an example of an organic shape, meaning it's just very rounded, right? Generally, you can define yo-yos as being competition oriented or not. An organic shape is not. Feels good in the hand. It may not be able to handle all the string tricks that you have. There are state competitions. There are regional competitions, things like East Coast Masters. Pacific Northwest Regionals is coming up as well. And then there are Worlds every year. This past year, Worlds was actually held in Cleveland. I had no idea. I'm really bummed I didn't go because this year it's in Budapest. So probably not going to make it to that one.
Our featured team brings you an exclusive Within the Margins, a student publication that highlights the diversity of identity within the Lawrenceville community.
So obviously In the Margins has had like a big impact on campus, and a lot of people are reading it, they love it. And so how do you feel that In the Margins has helped shape our campus's understanding of diversity and identity?
We started In the Margins the summer going into my sophomore year. I was on FaceTime one day with Layla Bell. It was Eid, which is like a Muslim holiday, and we were like, oh my gosh, like, this is so pretty. Wouldn't it be so cool if we had a space at Lawrenceville to kind of like display this beauty?
I see myself a very diverse, personality. And I think that In the Margins provides an outlet for people who come from diverse backgrounds.
The initial idea was that it would be a diversity magazine, but over the last issue, we've kind of seen that evolve into so much more, which has been really exciting.
I think In the Margins was just like a unique opportunity to think about our culture on campus a little bit more, and I don't know, just be more socially aware.
With most other publications on campus, at least for the Lawrence, a lot of the photography that I do focuses on different events such as performing art, so I'll like take pictures of the second form freshman Shakespeare, but with In the Margins, I feel like I get to have a lot more creative direction with it.
Something unique about In the Margins is we have different means of people's ways of expression. So we have our writing pieces, of course, and then we also have music and art.
I mean, photo shoots are definitely one of my favorite parts of the magazine because it's so cool finding visually interesting ways to represent people.
So a kit fullback style photography idea was awesome. And it was like, I think that really encapsulates the sort of celebratory nature of what we're trying to do.
We had them come in. We took a couple photos of them, and before we took photos of them, we had them write on a ID card or an index card anything they wanted us to know about them. Every person on campus, as his appearance, doesn't necessarily reflect who they are inside, and this is just a really great instance of this expression, I'd say.
The fact that anyone can be involved, just like being aware of something that makes you different, is a really important thing to know.
Now we will get a look into what the spring film class, taught by visual arts teacher Gail Dom, is producing. Third formers Lauren Kim and Zoha Khan created these one-minute videos.
Oh, Cinnamon, where you gonna run to? Cinnamon, where you gonna run to? Where you gonna run to? All on that day, will I run to the rock? Please hide me and run to the rock. Please hide me.
That's all for this week's show. As always, if you have a story to tell or a suggestion, please contact us. From all of us here at L10, thank you for watching and see you next time.